Hello students, I am Priya Patil from Department of Chemistry, Siketakur College, Autonomous. I am here to present supramolecular chemistry. Now what is supramolecular chemistry? That is chemistry beyond the molecules. In general, what happens? One atom or one group of atom and another group of atom binds together and forms the molecule. But in case of supramolecule, two giant molecules, or you can say the complex molecules, are come together, binds with each other via non-covalent interaction. Now, what is non-covalent interaction? Before that, what is supramolecular chemistry? So, the supramolecular chemistry is based on intermolecular non-covalent interactions. Now, we will see the types of non-covalent interactions in supramolecular chemistry. So, we will see one by one that the list is displaying that is hydrogen bonding, ion-ion bonding, ion dipole bonding, cation pi interaction, anion pi interaction, pi pi interaction, and van der Waals interaction. Now, the very first is hydrogen bonding, in which the hydrogen bond is electrostatic force of attraction between a hydrogen atom and particularly the second row elements such as nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. In diagram, you can see the donor atom, that is hydrogen, and the acceptor atom, which is having the lone pair of electrons, so that both the atoms can form the hydrogen bonding, which is simply a force of attraction. Now, what is the example of hydrogen bonding? So, the well-known example of hydrogen bonding is DNA, which is present in our cell. Now, how hydrogen bonding is there in DNA? So, there are four nucleotides. There are adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine. So, the hydrogen bonding is formed between adenine and thymine, in which two hydrogen bonds are there, and another hydrogen bonding is formed between guanine and cytosine, in which three hydrogen bonds are there. So, likewise, like in the same manner, similarly, adenine, guanine, and cytosine, adenine, thymine, cytosine, guanine binds with each other with hydrogen bonding and forms a helical-like structure of DNA. Now, second interaction is ion-ion interaction. It can be very strong bond, or it can be attractive or repulsive force. It is non-directional force and long range and highly dependent on the dielectric constant of the medium. Now, what is ion-ion interaction? In which two oppositely charged ions binds with each other by simply the force of attraction. In the diagram, you can say A having positive charge and B having negative charge are binds together and shows ion-ion interaction. Now, third one,